Hello, today is the 8th of May. You're tuned into daily coronavirus updates and this is The Wire. Number of people tested positive for novel coronavirus has crossed the 50,000 mark. 15,266 people have recovered so far and 1,783 people have died. Tamil Nadu recorded a new all-time single-day high in the number of cases. 580 people contracted the virus within 24 hours. A big chunk of these people were traced back to the Coimbatore market in Chennai. New Delhi also recorded the highest spike in a day. 428 people contracted the virus in a single day. The total number of coronavirus cases in the capital has crossed 5,000. Two personnel from the Border Security Force have succumbed to COVID-19 infection. Till now, over 300 members of the Central Paramilitary Forces and over 50 from the Army and Navy have tested positive for the virus. The security agencies have been on the front lines to contain the spread of the virus. Their facilities have been used for quarantining travelers and those suspected to have contracted the virus. So the recent spurt in cases involving members of the agencies have become a cause of concern. Good news coming in from Kerala, the state has reported zero new cases. Of the total 502 cases, 474 people have recovered. With almost 94% recovery rate, only 25 people are currently under medical supervision. All India Institute of Medical Sciences Director Dr. Randeep Guleria has told state media ANI on the 7th of May that as per modelling data and the way COVID-19 cases are increasing, it is likely that the peak may come in June and July. Dr. Guleria added that there are many variables to this and only with time we would know what have been the effects of lockdown. On the 4th of May, in a separate statement which slightly differs from what the AIIMS director said, Health Ministry's Lav Agarwal, responding to a question, said that because of lockdown and containment activities, we have been able to control cases relatively. The curve is relatively flat as of now, he said. When the peak will come, that's not the right way of looking at the situation. What is relevant is we know how to prevent the disease. The Uttar Pradesh cabinet cleared an ordinance today. The ordinance is named Uttar Pradesh Public Health and Epidemic Disease Control Ordinance 2020. It prescribes a maximum punishment of life term if death be caused by intentional COVID-19 affliction. Section 24 of the ordinance says that any person who intentionally inflicts another person with a contagious disease shall be punished with rigorous imprisonment for 2 to 5 years. Section 26 states that whoever causes death by infliction under Section 24 and 25 shall be punished with rigorous imprisonment for a term which shall not be less than 7 years. Section 26 states that whoever causes death by infliction under Sections 24 and 25 shall be punished with rigorous imprisonment for a term which shall not be less than 7 years but may extend to imprisonment for life and shall also be liable to pay a fine ranging from 3 to 5 lakh. Under Section 31, Part 1, no suit, prosecution or other legal proceedings shall lie against any person for anything which is done or intended to be done in good faith in pursuance of this ordinance. This ordinance will now be sent to the Governor for approval. According to a report published in The Hindu, a few private hospitals in the city which have been designated as COVID hospitals have fixed high rates for patients. One such hospital is charging patients 70,000 rupees per day for an isolation room, while another is requiring them to pay for personal protective equipment used by doctors and other staff every day. Inquiries done by the newspaper with some of the private hospitals in the city found that each of them were following their own pattern of charging patients under various heads. At one such hospital in the heart of the city, patients are admitted to isolation rooms and their samples sent for testing. The cost per day is 70,000 and patients are being admitted for a minimum of 2 days until results of the laboratory tests arrive. According to a report published in India Spend, over a quarter of country's 736 districts have no epidemiologist at the district level, and 11 states have no epidemiologists at the state level as well. As per a letter from the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Prime Minister Modi asked all state chief ministers to immediately hire epidemiologists or healthcare specialists trained in dealing with infectious diseases. Union Health Secretary Preeti Sudhan sent the letter directing chief ministers to hire epidemiologists on 7th of April. This was when India had recorded 124 deaths from COVID-19. The letter singled out 216 districts and 11 states across the country which had positions vacant, including Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, West Bengal, Haryana, Chhattisgarh and Assam. Sudhan's letter also said that hiring must be undertaken on a war footing, since epidemiologists were a critical element in the effective management of pandemics like COVID-19. If there have been indeed vacant positions for epidemiologists, etc., it is unclear why they were not filled earlier, considering India has been home to tuberculosis, HIV/AIDS for the last decade. To read more about this story, you can log on to The Wire Science or IndiaSpend.com. South Korean health authorities raised new concerns about the novel coronavirus after reporting last month that dozens of patients who had recovered from the illness later tested positive again. The findings suggested that some people who survived COVID-19 could become reinfected with the virus that causes it, potentially complicating efforts to lift quarantine restrictions and to produce a vaccine. But after weeks of research, they now say that such test results appear to be false positives, caused by lingering bits of virus which are likely not infectious. According to Korea Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, South Korea had reported more than 350 such cases as of Wednesday. The details of why and how such cases appeared in South Korea have been published on The Wire Science. Thank you for tuning in. Keep reading and watching The Wire and The Wire Science. We will see you tomorrow. Until then, stay safe.